Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I want to talk about the Visio. I want to talk about the Visio visual in Power BI. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, Visio. Visual in Power BI. Say that a couple of times. Visio, visual. I didn't realize I had never done a video on it. And someone said, hey, Patrick, can you show me how to set up the Visio visual in Power BI on our live stream? And I said, of course. Yeah, I'll do a video on it. So that's why we're here. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you need to do is make sure you have Visio installed on your machine and you need a subscription to Visio Online. And then you design out your Visio diagram. I do not proclaim to be a Visio expert, but I just kind of put something together using office furniture because at Guy in the Cube, we have a call center because so many people are calling in. They're requesting for Adam and I to come and speak or visit their facility. I kid. This is fictitious. So I'm using a call center. And basically what we want to do is color the chairs based on how many calls are in the queue, but I also want to display the name of the person that's sitting in that chair. So I'm going to use Visio for it and then I'll show you how to do it. So once you have the diagram created, we have three people that work in our call center and they're each assigned a seat. Once you have that set up, the next thing you need to do is you got to do some mapping. So for each one of the elements that you want to configure in Power BI, if you want to visualize it or overlay some data on it, you need to go into the properties for those elements and provide an ID or some way for the data to map to that particular element. And you can see right here for each one of these, for each chairs, I specified a number ID. So you can see ID is 1 for that one. And if we go to this one, I think I mapped this one to 3. And then if I go to this one, I think I mapped this one to the number 2. And then in your data, regardless of the source, you need to make sure that you have those corresponding identifiers somewhere in the data because you're going to need a field that contains that to do the mapping. So what I did was I just created a table in SQL Server. So you can see here's my table. I have a primary key. Then I have the ID here. That's going to contain that 1, 2, 3 for each chair. Then I have the date, time of the call, whether it was answered, and the employee name. And then I just inserted some data using SQL. You can use Excel, CSV files. You can use whatever data source you want. It was just easy for me to crank this out with SQL. Once you do that, then the next thing you need to do is get that data loaded in your PBIX file. And so I have it loaded right here. Click the ellipsis to get more visuals and choose get more visuals because it is not a native visual in Power BI. So you go here, type Visio in the search box, choose search and click add. Once you do that, you'll see the Visio visual right here in the visualization pane. Go ahead and click it. Once you click it, you'll see the visual. Before you can do anything with it, you must add the data that you're going to use to color the chairs or display as labels or whatever the identifier is. And so you can see there's an ID field. So I'm going to use that ID field. I'm going to drop it right there. And notice it does a change. It changes really quickly. I'm going to use my calls in a queue as a value, and I'm going to use my employee name as a value. And then what I'm going to do is you need to get the URL for that Visio diagram. So once you create that diagram, you need to save it up on OneDrive or SharePoint. You go out to a web browser and you'll see that Visio diagram saved up. If you click on the ellipsis right here, you'll see where it says embed. Go ahead and choose embed. You'll see the embed URL. So let's get that on our clipboard. Head back over to Power BI, paste that in, and choose connect. Once we connect, Power BI will do some magic behind the scenes, and you can see it's already colorizing things up. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start my script from scratch. I'm gonna head back over to SQL Server. All of this, the script, the Visio file, and the PBIX file, they'll be available in the description of the video below. Okay, so if you wanna check this out and kick the tires yourself, I'm making this all available. So I'm gonna start from scratch. So I'm gonna drop my table and recreate it. So now you'll notice there's nothing there. And I have auto refresh turned on for this particular page because I want you to see what happens when I add data. So I have page refresh set to 2 seconds, really fast. So we'll go here. You can see it's mapped to my ID. That's gonna match each one of those ID properties. The employee name, you can see it's set as text. So it's gonna display the employee name and you have some properties. And once we get some data, I'll show you how to set this up. And then the calls and queue, they're coloring it. And so you can see we have our own little legend here. So I'm gonna say from 0 to 1, we want this to be some kind of green. You can specify your own colors here. 2 to 4, we're gonna make this yellow. And then 5 to 100, you'll be red. So we'll make this red. 0 to 1, green. 2 to 4, yellow. And then 5 to 100, red. Hopefully you don't have anything in your queue beyond that. So we got it all mapped out. So let's go back over to SQL Server. So we're just going to insert a row of data here. into our table. Now you can see everybody's green because everybody falls in that category. And if you take a closer look, you can see some little labels there. So we'll go to employee name and we say, you know what, put this on the far left. So you can see how I can move that text to the left edge. I can say, put this above the shape. I can say, put this in the middle of the shape. And then if I want to increase the employee name, I can make it really big. If I want to, I can scroll up and I can collapse this and you can see Jane, Sue, Jim, it's all there. If I go insert some more data, so we're just gonna run this again, you'll see that everyone's gonna turn yellow. And then I have another little script here. If I go and insert this one just to make someone red, so we'll do that. And then you'll see that Jane turns red because she's got more than four calls in her queue. There's a few other things you can do here. If I expand this out and click on the ellipsis, you can see where I can copy the diagram. I can refresh the diagram. I can change the link. I can view this online. There's lots of stuff built in. You can zoom in and out. So if I zoom in right here, and then I click this, it brings it back into focus. If I click here, I can choose a particular section of the diagram to zoom in on. What do you guys think? Are you using the Visio diagram? Am I way too late and everybody's adopted and doing their own thing? I love to know. Are you running into any challenges? I love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.